In the field of astronomy, a few decades earlier, in the 1970s, there were a group of scientists who described how the universe came into existence, for which they got the Nobel Prize. This they called as the Big Bang. It's mentioned in the Quran 1400 years ago, in Surah Anbiya, chapter number 21, verse number 30, where it says, "Do not the unbelievers see that the heavens and the earth were joined together and we clove them asunder?" This Big Bang, which the scientists discovered recently, is mentioned in the Quran 1400 years ago.
The miracle claim of the Big Bang being described in the Quran is based on the following verses. Chapter 21 verse 30 says that the heavens and the earth were once one and were then clothed asunder, tore apart or separated. Chapter 51 verse 47 apparently says that Allah created the heaven and is still steadily expanding it, which apparently indicates that the Quran knew that the universe is expanding. And chapter 41 verses 10 to 11 are apparently miraculous because they describe the state of the heavens at some point as being like smoke. For these verses to be considered miracles, they have to match the following criteria. 1. The information in the claim must accurately describe reality. 2. It must be unambiguous. If there is an alternative meaning which is more simple than the meaning claimed, then the more simple alternative must be considered more likely. And 3. The verses must contain information which was not possible for anyone at the time to know except via divine revelation. Let's first look at chapter 21, verse 30. Test 1. Does the information in the claim accurately describe reality? The earth has not in any way been separated from the heavens. If we stand on earth and observe the heavens, we see the moon. If we stand on the moon and observe the heavens, we see the earth. Everything is still part of the same thing, the heavens. Nothing has been pulled apart from the heavens or unstitched from them. This verse states that the heavens and the earth were once one and then separated from each other, meaning that both existed in a combined form and that an act of separating them resulted in both existing. This is incorrect. The expansion event which occurred initially resulted in one big soup of the same stuff. As this stuff expanded and cooled, it became atoms. Gravity pulled these atoms together so tightly that they formed suns, which fused them together to make heavier elements. At some point, some of these suns would have exploded, releasing their heavy atoms into space, whereupon gravity acted once more to create a new sun and ultimately our planet. The universe existed for approximately 9 billion years before the Earth was even formed. During this time, countless stars formed, forged heavy atoms, and then exploded. This claim fails the first test. Test 2. Is it free of a more simple alternative meaning? In the Torah, Genesis 1, the earth and the heavens are created when God moves across the deep and then separates two bodies of water. One water is named the heavens, whereas the other is called the seas, in which land appears and life appears. This Quranic verse can just as easily refer to the incorrect creation story of the Torah, in which the heavens and the earth were once one entity called the deep, and were then separated to form two distinct entities, the heavens and the earth. This more simple explanation is therefore far more likely. It's interesting to note that the Quran verse immediately goes on to talk about life arising in water, which is exactly what comes afterward in Genesis 1:20. Anyone with even a passing interest in religion could easily have heard the creation story of Genesis and rephrased it using these very words. This verse fails the miracle test. It is ambiguous and is much more likely to represent a commonly held misconception of the time propagated by Jewish creation mythology. Test 3. Does it contain information only knowable via divine revelation? On account that the information in the Quran is wrong, this question is not applicable. Now let's look at chapter 51, verse 47. Test 1. Does the information in the claim accurately describe reality? The information presented by this miracle claim reflects reality. The universe is expanding. Test 2. Is it free of a more simple, alternative meaning? It's only recently that people have started to translate the Arabic word lamusiauna to mean an ongoing process of expansion. Both Pickthall and Yusuf Ali, for example, translate this word to mean that the heavens have been made a vast expanse. The Quranic commentator Ibn Kathir states that this verse means, "We made it vast." Note that this is a past tense and does not mention any ongoing process. The Lane lexicon describes this Arabic word to mean ample, abundant, wide, broad, spacious or roomy, and not growing or expanding. This verse has a much more simple meaning, that Allah made the heavens really, really big, or big enough to fit the sun, moon, and all the stars. Test 3. Does it contain information only knowable via divine revelation? One could make the same observation simply by standing outside on a clear night, looking up at the sky and saying, "Ooh, isn't that big?" And so on to the final miracle claim. Test 1. Does the information in the claim accurately describe reality? With the absence in 7th century Arabic of a word to describe gas, I'm willing to accept smoke in its place. However, the verse goes on to say that Allah spoke to both the heavens and the earth whilst the heavens were still in a state of being like smoke, which is incorrect because many stars would have been formed billions of years before the earth even existed. This claim fails the first test. Test 2. Is it free of a more simple, alternative meaning? According to these writings by Aristotle, it was commonly believed long before Muhammad's birth that there was lots of gas, vapour or smoke during the creation of the earth. The Quran's account of creation in this verse also reflects the incorrect creation order of Genesis, where God created vegetation on earth on the third day before the moon, sun and stars were created the day after. And here it is in the Quran. The earth is created first, then its nourishment, and then afterwards the heavens are formed and decked with stars. This claim fails the second test, as it is more likely to be a rewording of the creation story of Genesis. Test 3. Does it contain information only knowable via divine revelation? On account that the information in the Quran is wrong, this question is not applicable. The claim for cosmological miracles in the Quran is without any basis. The common origin of the earth and heavens is in fact an account of the separation of the deep to form the heavens and the earth in a geocentric creation story borrowed from Genesis 1 in the Torah. The expanding universe claim is a case of the claimant being creative whilst translating the meaning of the Arabic words in order to get them to match later scientific observations. If this Arabic word really does mean expanding, then why is it that no translator has used this translation until after this discovery was made? In fact, both Marmaduke Pickthall and Yusuf Ali were alive in 1927 when the expanding universe idea was first suggested. Both were also still alive when proof for the expanding universe was discovered in 1929 by Edwin Hubble. Pickthall died in 1936, approximately 7 years after this proof was discovered. Yusuf Ali first published his translation approximately 5 years after this proof was discovered, and didn't die until 1953, which would have given him over 20 years to revise his own translation. The claim that the Quran describes the early universe being a gaseous state is in fact clearly talking about the creation myth of the Jews, in which the earth existed in a solid form before the heavens had formed into the sun, moon, and the stars. Any claims for cosmological miracles in the Quran are completely without basis. In fact, these verses demonstrate a clear scientific error in the Quran, which I expect 99% of Muslims will refuse to accept, and the other 1% will tell me are allegorical. Allegorical for what? I am yet to discover.